Okay, now we're going to cover the 20th century, and we're going to address how treaty and removal allowed for U.S. to offer poor white males a chance to become landowners. So let's take a look at the first slide that we have here and appreciate, again, Thomas Jefferson is a famous president in the United States, and Americans look up to him as this benevolent figure because he wanted equality and he wanted democracy, but embedded in whiteness. And he wanted to ensure that the United States became a nation of small farmers. That's known as the Jeffersonian dream. So the American dream in the 19th century was about each white male person would be equal to each other as long as they had a piece of land. So when we take a look at land, and we address how treaty and removal allowed for the U.S. to offer these poor white males a chance to become landowners, we're following the Jeffersonian dream. So land policy evolved along the expansion of U.S. economic system. So I want to use the next slide to identify three broad categories to encompass economic growth. And so between 1700 to 1815, that period in U.S. history, we see small-scale agricultural production and merchant capital expansion occur. And between 1700 to 1850, the whole idea is to remove native peoples, make treaties with them, and then gain access to the resource. Then when the United States finally reaches the Mississippi and is able to secure its national borders against Great Britain's War of 1812, we see the rise of a market economy and the United States moves westward. So there's three broad categories to encompass economic growth as the United States moves westward. Between 1815 to 1860, it is known as the rise of the market economy. And then finally, after the Civil War, the United States goes on a protracted economic development process by which to connect markets. Markets, 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 from the East Coast to the West Coast. And that's known as industrial capitalism. So we have these three broad categories to encompass economic growth. And within these three broad categories, there's two factors that affect policy decisions to expropriate Native peoples from their land. And these two factors are very important in understanding how people are going to lose their land base. So let's take a look at Native peoples and their lands as they are taken from them. Let me talk about the two factors. The two factors that are affecting the policy decisions are availability of uncolonized territory, and then the other are the source of demand for the new lands. And so when you take a look at this particular slide, remember I'm sharing with you the source of demand for the new lands as the United States moves west. So it's important to recognize, again, as the United States moves west, how much unavailable or uncolonized territory is there, and that will allow for peoples to go and expand their position on the market. Then there's the source of demand for the new land. And of course, the source of demand with regards to these three major periods are the small farmers, Jeffersonian dream, the land speculators, merchants, and railroads that are going to expand with the United States as the United States moves west, takes over half of Mexico. And then from 1860 to the present, large-scale machine industry, lumber, oil, mining interest, nuclear interest, are going to take over in the 1960s. So there are three major periods that are impacting Native peoples as these lands are taken from them. First is 1700 to 1815. Those are known as the trade and treaty reservations. And it is during this time that, of course, we have Thomas Jefferson's notion of a nation of small farmers coming to fruition, because in these trade and treaty reservations, the whole idea is to disentangle Native peoples from their lands. And that's what the United States, the British, as well as the United States, will eventually inherit from the British, native removal policies. Then there's 1815 to 1860, and 1850 to 1860 is the removal of treaty reservations, or removal and treaty reservations. This is a very important time frame for when the United States, east of the Mississippi, as it moves west, is going to allow for the Jeffersonian ideal as the market system expands and allows for Americans to move west across the Mississippi. And all of the native peoples east of the Mississippi are going to be removed to a place called Indian Territory, which eventually become Oklahoma. Then there is 1860 to 2000, which are four eras that in the next segment I will discuss the four eras since 1860.